Good morning, students, and this is about part 2 of the chapter The Portrait of a Lady, written by Kushwant Singh. Let's have a quick recap with our previous session. In the last class, we have seen about the author, theme of the chapter, and the author's life journey with his granny. In the phase 1 of his life journey, he describes about his grandfather frame, which was hung above the mantelpiece, the author's childhood memories, which he had spent all his days with the merrily with his granny, and also he would like to remember all his days when he went to the spiritual school. The grandmother would help him to escort him to the school, and always they used to read about the sculptures. When they returned from the spiritual school, they used to feed the street dogs with the stale chapatis. Here comes the second stage, which becomes a turning point in between the author and his granny. The turning point arises when they moved to the city life. As they were in the same room, that is the grandmother and the grandson, they were in the same room, but there were no more conversation between them. Since the author is busy in going to the English school, the grandmother couldn't accompany him to the school since he was going to the school by motor bus. In the city, the grandmother couldn't find no dogs to feed the stale chapatis, so the dogs were replaced with sparrows by feeding a breadcrumbs to it. Also, the grandmother noticed that there were no teaching of sculptures of gods, only the music and science terminologies were given to the author. So she has very much disturbed and put up in the melancholy of sorrow. Next phase of his life, that is college life. The narrator went to the university and he was given a room of his own. There arises a bridging gap of friendship between the grandmother and the author. The grandmother slightly accepted her loneliness quietly. She was always busy with her spinning wheel and reciting prayers. She rarely talked to anyone. In the afternoon, she relaxed for a while. When she would feed the sparrows, she sat in the veranda. She broke the bread into little bits. Then she would throw them to sparrows. Hundreds of sparrows came there. They created a hell of noise, like chirping noise. Birds chirping, no? House was fully surrounded by the sound of chirpings. Some of the birds came and sat on her legs, other would sit on her shoulders, some would even sit on her head. She used to smile, but she never shook them away. Feeding the sparrows was the happiest hour, and it also becomes her one of the habitual activity. The next stage in his life was his high studies in abroad. The narrator decided to go abroad for high studies. There he was to remain away for 5 years. At that time, the grandmother was very old. The narrator thought that she could die any moment. So the narrator was worried, but the grandmother was not at all upset and she didn't show any emotions. In fact, she came to the railway station to see him off. Her lips moved in prayer, her mind was lost in prayer. Her fingers were busy telling the beads of her rosary. Finally, she kissed his forehead silently, The narrator even thought it was the last sign of physical contact between them. Since the grandmother was very old, the author thought that it was his lost contact, physical contact, because he's going to remain for 5 years in his abroad studies. He thinks that he can't predict his grandmother's life after returning to his hometown. But the grandmother didn't show any emotions, since she was completely indulged in the spirituality. Years rolled by. Here comes the narrator, returned home after 5 years of his abroad study. His grandmother met him at the station. She did not look a day older. She did not utter anything. She held him in her arms. She went on reciting her prayers. Even on the first day of the narrator's arrival, her happiest moments were with her sparrows. In the evening, a change came over her and she did not pray. Instead, what she did know, she collected some women from the neighborhood, got an old drum and started to sing. For several hours, she thumped the drum and sang songs of the homecoming of the warriors. So about the warriors, she tried to sing. Even the family persuaded her to stop to avoid overstraining, but they didn't do, because that was the first time that she did not pray. The very next morning, she fell ill with a mild fever. She realized that her end was near, so she didn't want to talk anymore. She felt that it would be a waste of time. She even ignored the protest of the family members and lay peacefully in bed, praying and moving her beads of rosary. And finally, the family members could suspect her lips stopped moving and her rosary fell from her lifeless fingers. Then she was lifted from the bed and customary laid her on the ground and covered with a red shroud, that is a cloth covering the corpse. That is a cloth used to cover a dead body, red color, that is red color shawl, according to their custom. Arrangements for her funeral were being made. It was evening. The sun lit her room and veranda with a blaze of golden light. The grandmother's corpse were surrounded by the thousands of the sparrows on the floor, and there was no chirping at all. Everyone over there felt sorry for the birds. Even the narrator's mother brought some breadcrumbs, the birds. She threw these crumbs to the sparrows, the narrator mother, but the birds took no notice of them. Then they carried her dead body outside, that is the grandmother's dead body outside. Immediately the sparrows flew away quietly. The crumbs of bread still remained lying there in the courtyard. Evidently, it shows that the sparrows had come to mourn the death of the grandmother. And that's the end. So pathetic the story was, no? Yes. Here are few points I've highlighted the values in this chapter. Just pause the video and go through the points. Now, it's time for you to take a part.
that is in the activity zone, your activity is, have you ever experienced your grandmother's care and affection? Have you ever admired her appearance? Start preparing an autobiography of your grandmother under this rubrics. If possible, you can paste her picture. This will be your post activity based on this lesson. So do this and pin it in your activity file. Thank you.